Hello, you're watching Proactive London. Joining me today is Benn Mikula. He is the CEO and Managing Partner at Cordiant Capital. Benn, very good to speak with you today.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you very much for having me on the show. It's a pleasure to be here.
You're very welcome. So, Benn, can you give us an overview of how social and technological change is driving digital infrastructure trends at the moment?
Cordiant Digital, which is one of the funds we manage at Cordiant Capital, we invest in what we perhaps inelegantly termed the plumbing of the internet. And the problem with the internet is that people use it and they don't give a great deal of thought as to the actual mechanics of how the data that they're consuming gets from A to Z. And in order to do so, it needs to traverse a highly complicated network, an international network, the principal components of which, there are other elements, but the principal components of which are fiber optic cabling in various configurations, mobile towers and the radio antenna sitting on those mobile towers, and then the data centers that serve up the information that people consume. And I think what happens is that all of this gets wrapped up in terms such as the cloud, which makes it seem very amorphous. I mean, the cloud seems delightful, but in fact, the cloud manifests itself in a series of quite ugly, boxy data centers, which are rapacious consumers of electricity and water. And those data centers, which have to be cooled because the amount of power being consumed in them is enormous, they have to be linked to the users, to you and I, through those fiber optic networks or over the wireless networks. And so it's quite possible that this conversation, which we're doing over video, is going through one of our data centers, or part of it is going through one of our data centers in New York at a place called 60 Hudson, which has been sitting at the intersection of North American communications for over 100 years. And what's interesting about the internet is that we are building a denser and denser overlay of communications infrastructure, but the pathways, some of them are 100 years old and follow the network that was first laid out for the telegraph. So hopefully that gives you just a little teaser of what's going on and what we invest in. And I'd be happy to pick apart some of the underlying trends that sit under the macro trend of data driving digital infrastructure construction.
Well, take us through some of those trends, Benn, but also how Cordiant is positioned to take advantage of those trends.
Well, I'll actually answer that in reverse order. We raised effectively $1 billion, the better part of 800 million sterling on the London Stock Exchange for what we term a core plus infrastructure fund. So a fund that invests in digital infrastructure seeking to combine capital appreciation as well as a 4p annual dividend, a target we reached vastly ahead of schedule. And what we did was raise a capital pool that could buy platforms under what we term a buy, build, and grow strategy. And what that means is we buy platforms of towers or of fiber optic networks or of data centers with existing blue chip customers, and then we expand them, investing capital in new facilities, often pre-leased to blue chip or government customers. So we have fully deployed the funding raised. We're looking to raise a second fund, which will be more of a value add, higher growth fund. And ultimately, when the trust market rebounds a bit, raise additional capital in the core plus fund. So that's how we're set up to provide investors with access to this market. Now, what's going on in the market are a number of things. The first and most obvious one that I think people interact with the most, though perhaps not the one that is gaining the most amount of newspaper headlines, is what's going on in your hand every day when you walk down the street and you send or receive a text or interact with some content on the internet. And all of that passes over the wireless network. And I'm sure many people in London, where I am today, are experiencing frustration because the network is overcrowded And frequently, when it is crowded and operating at capacity, things slow down. And so one of the elements that's going on is there needs to be further investment in the network. And part of that need for further investment is the result of European Union regulations that actually compressed profitability. It lowered prices, but the cost of that is a network that needs expansion. And this is happening at the same time as a new technology, a new radio technology called 5G is being installed in many markets around the world. And 5G is sort of the sumo wrestler of the wireless world. It can throw a huge amount of data a short distance, and that means you need to have more antennae, more masts to fill in the network to allow this new technology to thrive. So that's one trend. A second trend is happening in the world of data centers, and this is driven by the boom in artificial intelligence, which I'm sure many of the viewers are keenly aware of because of what it's doing to the Magnificent Seven stocks, so-called, in the United States, and powering the U.S. equity indices. Artificial intelligence is driving a lot of demand. How that demand will evolve over time is going to be of considerable interest. But what we're seeing right now is a requirement for more highly powered data centers. Because data centers, the capacity can be measured in total amount of electricity consumed in terms of megawatts at the facility level, but can also be measured at the actual power density at the rack. Within the data centers, you stack these servers up in a rack, and the power density, the amount of power pulled to that rack, that effectively bookshelf of servers, is rising and rising and rising, and the amount of heat being thrown off in the same amount of space is rising. That drives demand for more cooling. So there's a need for more data centers, and there's a need for data centers that have evolved with more air conditioning, more cooling, and more electrical capacity. And that's putting a strain on electrical grids in parts of the world. And you've even seen things such as moratoria imposed in certain cities, Amsterdam, for example, though they subsequently lifted it. But it is a matter of some concern and becoming quite an important local political issue as we strive to balance the desire for part of our population to watch TikTok and another part of our population to not experience brownouts or water shortages. So that's a second trend that's going on. And a third trend that's going on is data is having to move around vast distances. The amount of fiber optic cabling that's required is increasing, though tiny amounts of fiber can carry absolutely colossal amounts of data. But the networks need to run to new places, and data needs to move closer to the edge of the network, and that's causing some reconfigurations. So those are just three of the most interesting trends that we're watching quite attentively. There are others, I can assure you. This is a highly dynamic sector. Many people think of infrastructure and they think of something such as a bridge or a toll road, which has a great deal of endurance. Its use case doesn't change. You know, a road is a road is a road. The cars driving on it may change, but the road has unyielding characteristics. Digital infrastructure is vastly more dynamic. So the trends we're talking about today may well have evolved in a year's time. Hopefully that gave you a little bit of a flavor.
You mentioned those trends, Ben, and obviously some of them did have problems that need to be resolved. Are you seeing solutions at Cordiant Digital Infrastructure that can be applied to those, particularly as you look at raising new funds?
Yes, and existing companies, because of course we've now built strongly cash flowing platforms that are expanding. So I'll give you an example. We have a European a tower company called CRA, and we reinvested some of the profits in building a data center business within that company, because this company had a large number of towers as well as a fiber optic network. And that business is now generating about a fifth. It's on track to generate about a fifth of its revenues from buildings that we repurposed They were old broadcast facilities that had fiber and power and were well located. And we repurposed them as edge data centers. And then we took a site which had some superfluous antennae, which already had a substation on it, some water, and it was connected to the fiber network with fiber we actually owned. And we're putting up a major campus there. This is actually outside of Prague, which is not only a lovely and wonderful city to visit, but it's also, according to the consultants Cushman and Wakefield, an emerging European data hotspot. And so we'll be able to build a very high capacity campus there. And to your question about what are we doing and how are we addressing some of these issues, well, you'll notice that all of the data centers I talked about are on brownfield sites. We're not doing what you're seeing in Northern Virginia, for example, where pristine and in some cases historic farmland is being bulldozed and a data center plopped on top of it. We're also making use of the existing electrical grid. And we're moving the company to using 100% renewable energy, up from below 25%. And at the major data center campus, we're looking at having 5 to 6 megawatts of on-site solar on a private wire basis that will help to further, reduce the load of this important new facility on the grid. So those are some of the things that we're doing that combine a profit with perhaps a sense of being a better corporate citizen.
Ben, I mean, you mentioned that second fund. Where are you seeing the best investment opportunities at the moment for new investment?
Well, for that will be a GPLP fund focused on a very different kind of digital investing. But for the first fund, where we still have some capacity left over from our Eurobond and where we hope to be able to raise significant amounts of capital in the future, we're continuing to see that towers, edge data, interconnect data, which are some digital crossroads where all of these streams come and meet. And obviously, some of the larger campus developments, as well as backbone fiber networks, those are the places that we're, whether we have deployed capital, we will look to deploy incremental capital. And probably if we're to raise new funds in Cord on the London Stock Exchange in, say, a year's time, we'd probably still be deploying it in those. And we're seeing, it's curious, in the middle market where we invest in this buy, build, and grow, we're seeing somewhat more opportunities in Europe and the United Kingdom than we are in the United States, because in the United States, a lot of what's going on is very much a scaled up game where the check sizes are much larger. But obviously when you're doing those larger deals, you're also paying higher multiples. So we're quite interested in staying in the middle market because you get better entry pricing there and therefore make more money for investors. So that's a lot of words, but if I could perhaps attempt to sum up this answer for your viewers, we're seeing a few trends around these key themes, and we're investing at the intersection of those trends and the middle market under our buy, build, and grow strategy. And we think that's just a great place to deploy capital.
Well, Ben, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress you make, but thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Not at all. A great pleasure. Thank you for having me on the show.
You're very welcome. That's Benn Mikula. He's the CEO and managing partner at Cordiant Capital.